Okay, so this is recording now. I just wanted to test this out and record right onto YouTube. So I'm about to go for a run. I'm gonna put on my, I guess, oxygen deprivation mask here to help my body adapt to a different circumstance with reduced oxygen. I know it's not, you know, simulating elevated training, I understand that. But it does simulate like swimming underwater. So, you know, there's an energy system that your body uses. It's called ATP when your body's doing activities without or minimal oxygen. And that would be like swimming underwater. So I'm gonna be doing wearing the mask and depriving myself of a little bit of oxygen here. The lighting is out. There you go. So anyways, I also want to talk about natural talent. Natural talent actually has to come down to the point of where you're using your own raw ability. So when I talk about raw ability, that means with no aids of enhancers or anything like that, no pre-workouts, nothing like that. It's interesting because I actually came from a bodybuilding background, and I used to use tons and tons of supplements. I went off to a course called SEAL Fit. Back then they had an immersion academy, which was like pretty much like 3 weeks long. I don't think that's there anymore. They do have a 3-day course though. And I was there, and I literally brought a bag of supplements, a duffel bag of supplements. And I had my pre-workout, and then I had creatine in my water bottle. And it was like literally... the first events, we were doing runs on hills and stuff like that. My leg cramped, and I couldn't move my leg. This is pretty much a trademark point in that experience that, you know, that really taught me a lot of things. There's so many things that I learned from them, but this is one of the moments there. But anyways, you know, I realized, you know, like these supplements weren't helping me. And you know, they're teaching me how to eat properly, and I really came back out of SEAL Fit and got really deep into learning about nutrition and stuff like that, and how food helps, because they're teaching me about nutrition there, and then and it was working. I ended up throwing away my supplements there, and you know, and my body actually started to improve in functionality. It's funny because now when you look at the SEAL Fit website, they actually say zero supplement policy. There's zero supplements allowed at SEAL Fit. And in Buds, I was reading about it, a book, Warrior Leap by Dick Couch. Like creatine is banned completely from Navy SEAL training. So, you know, like I often really love to talk about mental resiliency, physical, psychological resiliency. And that really grew from when I left SEAL Fit, because I'm like, okay, wow, you know, like I left out of there. This was one of the hardest things I've ever done. And like, especially there's a civilian version of Hell Week, which is 50 plus hours where you're still being grinded, you're still being worked, and you're awake for 50 plus hours. And yeah, so it was pretty rough. But anyways, I learned that there was this magical thing that happened when you're in this hard place, and you start to have epiphanies about who you are, you know, and your capabilities and what you can do, and you know, I never got any of that working hard when I was taking something or whatever, you know, like, because when you're relying on something that to give you this resiliency, you're giving the power to that thing that you're taking. So for instance, if you're doing a pre-workout, you're going to assume that that pre-workout is what made you powerful. And it's not you yourself that made you powerful, but it was that thing that you took. So you're taking away that power from yourself and saying that, man, I could do this on my own, as opposed to, oh, you know, I need the aid of this and that. All right, so in order to build resiliency, we need to actually have, you know, this natural grit that we have to develop naturally, that we've overcome it, that we've overcame it, you know. So, you know, it was easy. If I didn't pass those supplements, I would have said, you know, I made it because of these supplements, you know. But when those supplements actually hindered me and I put those aside and I just stopped taking them and I started eating the way they told me to eat. And, you know, I just started working out, right? So I came out and I've been doing things like extreme fasting to develop resiliency. There's a lot of science between resiliency and fasting, but fasting also has a lot of benefits. I've done polyphasic sleeping. There's no health benefits to polyphasic sleeping, but to be honest, it's helped me out. Now I have a newborn, so you know, it's helping me out a lot. My energy levels are still good throughout the day as long as I'm getting in my naps, which polyphasic sleeping is encourages you to do. I've ran, you know, in a muscle shirt like this in minus 20 degree weather, you know, ice barrel dives, stuff like that. Early, super early, like 2:30 morning. Murphy's and stuff like that. I actually beat my best Murphy time during the Memorial Day there, Murphy Challenge, and yeah, you know, and more, you know, I'm just trying to practice resiliency by pushing myself by natural means. You know what I mean? So yeah, I mean, do I still supplement? I do, right? But I do not supplement the way I used to. You know, I got a one a day multivitamin, my omega-3s, occasionally as a pick me up. And, you know, when I'm not really working on resiliency, when I'm just trying to get in and work out, I might take like a fat burner or something like that. But for the most part, if I'm training for resiliency, like today, I'm going to be using, the face mask, right? So, but I'm going to be doing that based on natural talent. If I'm supplementing anything, it's more like I'm supplementing tools, like again, like the face mask and whatever. But yeah, so why has mental resiliency become such a big deal for me? I guess this is 7 minutes in. I don't want to take too much time. We'll talk about that the next one. But I find that there's a great importance in terms of resiliency and success. And I mean, just saying resiliency and success, you can probably already correlate the two without any explanation, but I'll get into my explanation with that another day. So hopefully this YouTube filming right directly onto YouTube works, and yeah, so if it works, I'll do it again. All right, see you guys later.